The success of the Basics of Gracie Jiu-Jitsu instructional series, along with a free bonus tape, How to Handle Stand-Up Aggression, inspired hundreds of students to write me requesting this series on street self-defense. In these tapes, I'll show you how to handle real-life threatening attacks using our proven jiu-jitsu techniques and prepare you for the violent streets of the 90s. In this tape, I'll show you how to defend yourself from chokes, shoulder grabs, bear hugs, and club attacks. Now, brother Royce, once again, it's going to help you demonstrate the techniques that we're about to see. Let's assume that an attacker is always bigger and stronger than you. And this time, he's got you in the neck, in the front choke like this. The first thing you want to do is protect your neck to give you more resistance and so he can't squeeze your neck too much. First thing, number one. Then, you bring your head under the arm. One more time, Royce. There's no way that two thumbs could prevent the whole body from bending forward. You can do with the step or you can do without the step. You could simply do something like this. But if you want to increase the distance and increase your leverage, you're going to step back and your head will fall below at the same time. The idea is to tighten up your neck muscles and then come under so that you ensure the fact that he can't hurt your neck while you're bending forward. That's it. Once again, more fat inside. Yeah. So the person's got your neck. That's the move. So let's review the same choke from another angle. Which is when the person grabs your neck like this. Tighten up your neck, put your chin down, and take a step back under the arm. Protect the neck and go under the arm. If you want, one more time, please. You don't even have to step back. You can just go under to either side. The idea is that your body develops so much leverage when the person puts the hand here by tightening the neck that you can't stop that move. Or you can step back. Another variation for the same kind of attack is if the attacker, when he grabs your neck like this, you want to hold his arm. Take a step forward and drive your hand through so that you can then get ready to flip him from here by doing this move. I want you to observe that once you hold the arm and take a step, the idea is to control his upper body so that when you bring your knee, you want to lower your hip so that the hip will travel easily in front of him. Be relaxed so that your movement can come in this way. What flips him is not the hand forcing his head down, but instead, my head goes down as I straighten my legs. That's what does it. One, two, three. As I put my head down, he goes up. Hold the elbow, take a step, and hit me. The purpose of this back hand is to free the squeeze on the neck. So when your shoulder comes through, it relieves the pressure of the neck. That's what you're looking for. From here, you adjust your base, and as I put my head down, you put me on the ground. You hold the elbow with one hand to make sure he doesn't change his mind. This man will come through, straight up, and hug the person close to you. That's the idea. So you can have a good controlled grip on his upper body. Adjust your legs, lower your knees, and as you put your head down, straight your leg to lift him up this way. Once again. One, two, three. Head down. Another variation for a choke is when your aggressor squeezes your neck with one hand, like this. Okay? What you want to do here is hit with the palm of your hand, you hit the wrist in order to deflect the move and then come back with an elbow strike.
protect your neck, turn this way and hit with your elbow. Change sides the same move. I want to hit this way and turn here. Be careful that you don't do this and punch the wall. Keep your hand open so that you can come back with an elbow hit immediately. Just again, just protect your neck, turn in here. Other side. I want to turn this way and then come back with an elbow. Once again, squeeze the neck. Okay, that's what you want. If he's got, that's the move you want. Protect your neck. If you've got two hands on the neck, like this, I want to reach for both hands with my fingers so that I can feel which finger of his is looser. Peel one finger out and then grab his wrist and then break the finger back this way. When you reach for the finger, be sure that you don't grab the hand this way, so you have no leverage to bend it back. You want to make sure that your hand comes out this way so that you can break it easier backwards. Once again, so the hands go back, feel the finger, and then crank it back. First thing you want to do, select the finger, either one, any finger. One, two, and then crank it back. The idea of using both of your hands is because you don't know which finger you're going to end up with. So at this point, you put your both hands by the touch. You can feel which finger is coming out. Once you select the finger, your second hand goes under, and then you bring it back to break the hand. That's what you have this. So if he's using two hands, squeezing against the wall, you bring both hands up, pick a finger, and then crank it back. That's the idea. So once again, if the person's got two hands on their neck, you reach for both hands, select the finger, confirm the grip to prevent him from escaping, and then crank the finger back to break the finger. If the attacker this time is pushing you against the wall, like this, holding you against the wall, I want to hold his arms, step out of the way, hit him against the wall, and then come with a new strike. He's pushing against the wall here, hold the elbows, make sure he stays here with me. I want to step clear out of the way, hit him against the wall, and then come with a new strike. The other side. You can choose the side, either side, hold the arm. I'm going to step away from him, hit him against the wall, and then come with the knee strike. I'll come this. One, two. As you move out of the way, what you want to do here is that you want to shove his head bang into the wall, and then come with the knee strike. Another very common aggression is when the person comes up to you and grab you by the shoulder like this, carry you or something. The hand will go around, bending his arm, hold my own wrist, so that I can then crank it up this way. So the guy grabs by the shoulder, my hand will go around, hold the wrist, and then crank it up. You want to be sure at this point that you don't do this kind of movement, because a strong attacker here could prevent your arm from coming down. The trick is to bring the elbow down to bend his arm so that you can then come under and lift the arm up this way. Once again, hold. One, two, and crank it up this way. If the attacker grabs your shoulder like this, and as we go around, he lets go of the shirt and straightens his arm, I want to hold my wrist, bring my leg in front of him, and then snap the elbow the other way. And then turn that way. You want to make sure at this point that you don't stay so much in base that he can push you back and throw you off balance. So by the time the hand goes around and he straightens the arm, be leaning forward so that your weight is already going that way. One more time, please. One, and that way, that's the move. With your weight falling that way. Okay. This one grabs the arm, one, and then two from me. Once again, one, and then crank it up. Again, remember, the idea is to bring your elbow straight down to bend his arm, and then lift the arm up this way. If he straightens the arm, I'm going to put my weight and then fall forward with it.
One, two, and then turn that body down.
One more time, please.
Wrap it up. Two, and then snap that way. Okay. Good.
Another sequence that is part of this tape is when the attacker comes up to you but from the front and grabs you in a bear hug over the arms like this. Your first movement is going to be to place your hands on his hip and rest your elbow against your hip bone to prevent him from bringing you any closer. Hold on tighter, please. Here, like, that's the idea. He can bring me close, but not closer than this. I can keep him away. From this position, keeping the hand on the hip, I want to step around him. Keep my legs in here. After the leg is over, this man holds the elbow, my hip comes across, and I then lift him up. Now, please. So number one is this, keep him away. Two, three, four. So, and then lift him up. It's important that you keep your hand on the hip, because if you let go of this hip to hold the arm now, a strong person can bring you closer, and now it's going to be difficult for this leg to go around. So be sure that you keep this space open by maintaining this knee on the hip until your leg comes across. Now you can hold on to the arm and then lift him up and take him down. That's the knee. Then you might ask, well, what if the person comes up and sneak up on you and holds you close enough that you got length on the hand as far as bringing the hand into the hip? Once again, ideally, as soon as I'm already bracing myself, even before he gets a hold of me, you can see the mass coming towards you, you can block him. You don't have to wait for him to grab and then do the move. So I'm already here, keeping the distance. Step to the side, and then coming across, to throw him over. But what if the guy does get a hold of you and holds you this tight? Now my hands won't fit. You go to your tiptoes, put your hands, lower your body away, step to the side, and then come in for the throw. Let's see the same movement from another angle. One, hold the brace in here, step to the side, step through, hold the elbow, and then put my head down. One more time, please. One, two, three. Alright. And then have a few. So once again, if the person gets you too close here and keeps you tight and your head won't fit, go to your tiptoes, create the space, walk to the side, and then come in. Another kind of bear hug is if he's from the front and grabs you under the arms like this, holding you close over the arms. Now I don't have the leverage to keep him away because the hands are inside, I can't push him away anymore. My hands are free so I can take a step back, put both hands like this on his chin, and push him away until he lets go. And complete with a knee here if I want. Hold him tight like this. One, two, and three. Once again, hands, please. Don't push the person back this way. You want to put the shin up that way. The hand is pushing this way, not this way. This move, my hands go behind the chin and then push my heel and then complete the knee here. Okay, once again, please, the same thing from the other knee. So if the attacker grabs you here, you want to step back with this leg, both hands. The hand should cut like this. And then push him away, and then knee hit. One more time. One, two, three. One more detail that could help execution of this technique is if the person grabs you under the arm like this, and he's real strong, you can't push this up, you go to his nose with the palm of your hand, and then drive it back. And then complete the knee here. Let's do that on this side. So he's going this way, my hands go here, he's real strong, my hand will slip to the nose and then drive him back. And come in with the knee here. Okay? Now, bear hugs. If the person
person comes from behind and grabs you over the arm, to try to force the arms apart, it's going to take a lot of strength. I might not be able to do it, especially if the attacker behind you is stronger and heavier. So what you want to do here is, first thing is to put yourself in base and bend your arms. The idea of the arms bent is to prevent him from bringing his arms down. Okay, so I'm like this, he can slide the hands down. But when I keep my arms bent, it limits, he can't move them anymore, so I know where his arm is going to be. From this position, I will step my leg behind him into this position here, control my, establish my base, and with the legs, lifting him up this way. It's not the arm strength. The trick is to scoop him up with the hip. Once again, one. Two. The trick of the movement, once again, one person, is that I want to go from this position, from this base, I want to go around into another base. So one, two, into another base. Be sure that you don't step and lose yourself in balance. One,
two. One, a group behind, two.
The trick here is that my knees being bent, I lower my hips so I can lift him up with the scooping of the hip. One more time, please. One, two. As I lift him up, he goes over and ends up over there. To prevent the attacker from letting go of you and running away, which he could do, when I drop in base and step behind him, both of my hips over here, but my hands are free so I can control his knees. Not to pick me up, to pick him up with the arm strength, but just to prevent the person from running away. So the hands are here, just to keep him hugging close to me, so that I can now lift him up and guide his fall. One, two. Be sure that you have yourself in a comfortable base. And when you lift him up, do not lean away because there's too much weight and he could fall over your knee. Lift him up and end up in an erect position. He should fall next to the leg, but never on your leg. So if you do this movement, go up, throw him and move out of the way, you could be sacrificing your knee. So base. To lift him up and end up in a straight position so that he falls next to the leg again, but never on your leg. One more time, Horst, please. One, two. Establish your base. Grab the knees, get up straight, and let him fall. So the position is, the level is from here. That's the move you want. Just scoop him up with the hip. Two. Trap the knee, and as I straighten my leg, that's what throws him. It's not the hands off, it's the hip movement. Two. Trap. One. Two. Lift him up. I should emphasize that when a person grabs you over the arms like this, and you put yourself in base, go behind him, at this point, it would be better if instead of completing the throw, for you to get the sense of just lifting up your opponent. Don't throw each other at this stage until you know exactly what you're doing. So the drill at this point is one, two, and practice enough that you can be comfortable doing this move. The throwing part is easy, but if your partner is not accustomed to the idea of falling, you might hurt yourself on the training process. Another aggression from behind is if the attacker now gets you in a bear hug under the arms. He's holding me now so close that I can't go behind him. He's too close to me at this point. My hip doesn't have the mobility to go behind him anymore. So I'm going to put myself in base again.
Put my hands on the ground and reach for his foot so that I can bring the foot up, wedge my elbows on my knees, and as I sit down, I can now break the knee this way. Bing.
Once again, please.
Base, I put my hands on the ground, and as I grab his foot and push him down, I don't want to lose my balance and snap his knee by accident.
If this happens to be done in a controlled situation, you should be aware of what you're doing at this point. But when practicing with a friend, you don't want to just fall back and hurt his knee.
One, grab the foot. The sitting on the knee is what makes him fall down. But I'm in base. I'm holding this and I'm in base. I'm ready to break if I want to.
You should never lose your balance and fall back because you can accidentally injure somebody's leg very much. One more time, please. So if the person comes from behind and holds you under the arms so tight that you cannot step behind him because his body is really close to yours, you want to put yourself in base.
Protect your hands. So if you go right for the leg, you might lose your balance and hit your head on the ground. So the hands are here to make sure that you have a good base. From this position, find his foot. As you pull the foot forward, brace your elbows on your knees and then sit back to break the knee if you want to at this point.
Snap the knee. Let's see the same movement from an angle here.
So
we
have base, hands on the ground. Grab his foot and I sit in the knee to break it if I want now. That way. Once again. One, two, three. And break the leg if you want.
One more time, please.
Okay. And then break the knee.
Be aware of this one more time, please.
And I do this. If I just grab his foot and lift it up, he doesn't fall. If I just lift his foot up like this, or that doesn't make him fall. What makes him fall is when I put my weight down and then snap back the knee. So your movement is to do this, grab his foot, and as I sit down on his knee, the weight of my leg with his knee on my behind his knee, that's what forces him to go down.
That's a good move.
And then I sit down, and I cannot break his knee.
There it is. One more variation on this move is if the person comes from behind and picks you up. I don't have now access to his leg. But if I hook my leg here, pull myself down, I can complete with the same kind of movement. And then bring the knee. So what we're adding to this, if the guy comes from behind and catches me here, I want to hook my leg, pull myself down, establish my base once again, find his leg, and then sit on the knee to break the leg. If he's so strong that he lifts you up and you can't come down, you can use an elbow strike to the face, a heel kick to the groin, but still the idea is to pull yourself down, find his foot, and then sit and snap the leg.
And that's one more, please. Picks me up, bing, I'm gonna strike, pull myself down, and then grab the foot, and then snap the knee.
Once again, let's review the movement from another perspective. Person lifts me up.
I can't get to the leg, I can use an elbow strike, a heel strike, and then pull myself down, find his foot, take him down, and then snap the knee if I have to. I can use my hands to help down. Base. And then break the knee down.
Mm-hmm. In these sequences, we're going to address the defense against a club attack. Is close to you like this, and from this distance, which is anything within arm's length distance, is considered a close attack. When the person lifts up the club, your movement is to take a step forward, reach underneath the arm, get a hold of the tip of the club, and then pull it out. As you take a step forward, the hand moves at the same time simultaneously. Once again, hands, please. So that's the move. One, two, and then pull it out. One more time. You don't want to go under his arm. You want to go outside of the arm. If you go here, sometimes you might not be able to get a hold of the club. When you come to the outside, you can't prevent that. What happens is by holding the end of the club and this hand on the wrist, there's no way that we can stop my hands from peeling the club out of his grip. One, two, three. We step in here together. One, two, three. I mean base. Because if he wants to hit me and drag the hand back, I mean base, so I can now find that club and take it away. If you forget the step, once again, hands please, he can then pull me forward, I'm going to be losing my balance. You should take a step to establish your base here, second hand comes in, and then you pull the club out. From the other side, please. One, two, three. Step in here together. One, two, and out. Okay. If the attacker is close to me like this, and he goes for the hip, support. And as I grab the club, he slides the hand away, my hands are already here. I will continue with this motion, step behind his leg, and then bring him down quickly. Two, three. Now from here, I'm gonna bring it down. Complete this way. Two, three. Once, of course, once I design the person in this position, I can punch, I can strike, pull the club out, break his arm. There we go. One more time. My idea is always grab the club, and if he slips away, my hands are going to be automatically in this point. So I embrace the arm, so that he can't use that club anymore, step behind his leg, and as I bring my head down, I will straighten my right leg. To then complete the elbow strike for a punch. The other side, please. One, two, three, four. And unlock our strike. One, two, three, four. If he's tall enough that I cannot reach him with my arm, it becomes a long, I mean, an out of reach kind of attack. So in this case, if I did the same movement, he would hit my arm here and seriously injure my arm. So what I want to do here is I want to take a step forward and let the club slide so I can trap his elbow, walk to the side, go for this move, and complete the throw. Any kind of attack with a club, if it's out of the reach of my hand, it's going to be called a this move. One, two, three, four. The hip comes across easy. Head down. And down he goes. One, two, three. I want to take a second here, let's move on this way, please. I don't want to bring my hand this way so that the club could come on the inside. The trick is to keep your hand against your ear so that this deflects the arm so I can trap the arm, go in, and then come in for the hip through. The idea here is to, as if I want to listen to my shoulder, trap the arm, and then come in with the hip through. Get from this side here, please. So the person said, move, that's the move. One, two, three, bang if you need to. And this one is one more. Yeah. So the movement is this way. Yeah. The hand goes out. The idea is to deflect, to have my arm in such an angle that even if it goes this way, I'm safe. And if it goes far that way, I'm safe. So the movement is to deflect that hip. Trap the arm and then bring it down to the ground. Another variation for a person with a club is when he grabs the club like this and wants to swing the club at you, doing this kind of motion. What you want to do here is block the arm, hold him by the waist, bring him down, stab the position on the top, and come with it so I can get the club out of his hand. The trick here is timing, so you don't want to come in now because you're going to get here. You want to come in as soon as the club goes in front of you.
Hold the waist.
Again.
Take it down. Establish your base. Get the club out.
Establish the position here. Bring him down.
Establish my position. Go for the target.
Come on. One idea is when you're practicing this move is that you might want to use a belt. So that you don't take a chance in getting hurt when you're practicing a move. So that even if you get touched by this, you won't have a major consequence. So the movement is to do this and just close the distance so that you can get used to the idea of close movement. The distance in good timing. It doesn't matter which side you're going, if the club is going this way or if it's going this way. As long as you make sure that as soon as the weapon goes in front of you, that's the time to close the distance.
Establish your position here, and then go for the drive.
When practicing these techniques, do it slowly. Don't fight with your partner. Be sure to help each other so both of you can learn the techniques correctly. In tape 2, you learn how to defend yourself against collar and hair grabs, kicks, and success of the basics of Gracie Jiu-Jitsu instructional series, along with a free bonus tape, How to Handle Stand-Up Aggression, inspired hundreds of students to write me requesting this series on street self-defense. In these tapes, I'll show you how to handle real-life threatening attacks using our proven Jiu-Jitsu techniques and prepare you for the violent streets of the 90s. In the second tape, you'll learn how to defend yourself against collar and hair grabs, kicks and knife attacks.
If the attacker comes up and grabs him by the collar like this, I want to confirm his grip by holding the wrist this way. The second hand, I'm going to slap the elbow as I step forward at the same time. I want to wedge my elbow on my hip so that he can't push this down. If I don't rest my elbow, he can force my arm back. But as I wedge my elbow on my hip, he can't push this down anymore. So I confirm the grip, take a step, wedge the elbow on my hip, and now step behind him. To break, I will push the elbow up with this hand and lift it up to stretch the ligaments on the shoulder here. One more time, please. So he grabs the collar, I'm gonna confirm his grip, take a step and wedge my elbow on my hip this way. From here, the leg steps behind him. I'm gonna keep his hand glued to my chest all the time so that he doesn't break away from me. So hand stays here, this hand on the elbow is the one that actually brings the, it causes the pain on the stretch and the ligament. So when I lift this up, one, rest the elbow on the hip, and then step behind him to then break the arm by lifting the elbow up. Let's do the same thing from the other side, please. So confirm the grip, one, two, three, and as I lift the arm, I'll stretch the ligaments on the shoulder. Of course, you can snap up if you want. He grabs the collar. I want to confirm the grip. Be sure that you don't grab your thumb this way. This is what you want. You won't grab with your thumb down. The thumb should be up. One. Second hand, I'm going to slap the elbow, take a step forward, and then end up behind him so that I can lift the elbow up this way. If you want to change your hand this way, it's fine. Whatever feels more comfortable, this way or this way. Remember, the back hand is the one that forces the elbow to go up. So that's the motion. One, two, three, and four. Some of you might have noticed that as we practice the techniques, when I start to squeeze, hold it here, tap. You should get accustomed to the concept that as soon as you start feeling pain, organize a code between you and your partner so that when you feel the pain, you tap, and you kind of get that understanding going from the beginning. So one, two, three. So as soon as he taps, I know that's the limit of the pressure I should put on. So this way you have that agreed upon. This next move is when an attacker grabs you by the collar and turns the wrist. I want to confirm the grip and glue his hand to my chest so that he can no longer turn the wrist backwards. His hand is now solid in this position. I glue it to my chest. Then I'll bring my head down, which will force his body to bend down with me. The leg goes outside, clapping his foot so that I can, if I want, bring it down here. As I twist the wrist, either he falls down or I'll break his wrist. So he grabs the claw. One, two, three, and then snap it down this way. Once again. One. Each of our hands should grab half of his hand, like biting half of the hand with this, and glue it to my chest to prevent him from turning the hand. One. Head down. Two. Three. And then bring the hand all the way down. Four. So as he holds my collar and turns, I grab this. I'm turning my foot to make it easier for me to turn my body. Then this leg comes around, and as I put my head down, I'll force him down. Let me turn this from the other side first. One, two, three, and then bring him down all the way. Okay. One last one. I'll grab the shirt, move to my chest, head down. And then bring it down. Okay. A common situation as far as the collar grab goes is if the person grabs their shirt like this and keep their hands together, like shaking all. Then I'm going to step to the side and hold my own wrist. One. One. From here, I'm going to bring my leg in front, snap the hands away and come back with an elbow strike. One, two, three, and then four. Come back. One more time, please. So he grabs the shirt. I'm going to take a step to the side and hold my own wrist. Bring my leg across. Yank your weight away and come back with a strike. Other side, please. So he grabs here. Take a step to the side and hold my own wrist. Bring the leg across, neck the hands away, and come back with an elbow strike. One, two, three.
Almost try.
If the attacker were to hold the collar, grab you by the shirt, and spread the hands, keeping a distance between the arms, I will now bring my hands together this way. Almost as if I'm praying. My hands going this way, straight up, and I can then hold my own wrist this way. If I keep the hands down, he can pull the arms away. So here what you want to do is that you want to bring your hands up so that he can't pull the arm out. Once again, once. So the hands go one, two, and I bring the hands up so that I can walk to the side, bring my leg from the outside, and then lift it over this way. Every time you throw a person on the ground, you can now rest your knee on his ribs, trap the arm, and then hyperextend the arm to break the joints of the arm. One more time, please. One, two, three. I take my time. Observe that my leg is bent. What flips Royce is not my arm pushing him over, but as he gets to the point here, as I straighten my leg, he swept over. Hold the arm, rest the knee here, and then I lean back to hyperextend the arm. Let's keep in mind that when your hand comes through and you trap the arm, the walking around is whatever you need to do to find yourself continuously in a solid base. So I'm going to clear the position here. When I step through, you don't have to pivot your feet a little bit to get yourself comfortable at this point. So that you can then shoot. Whatever kind of adjustment you need to do at this point, do it so that you feel comfortable and solid in your base, so that you can then hyperextend the arm and break. Hyperextend the joint of the elbow. On the other side, please. So we've got you here. Both of the hands coming together. Trap the arm. Bring the arm up, step to the side. So if you need to turn your feet here, do the wrong bit to get yourself in a comfortable base. Head down, straighten the arm, establish your base here, and then hyperextend the arm. One, two, head down, adjust your feet, put them over, establish your base and complete with something like that. Another variation of these collar grabs is if the person comes up and grabs with the thumb down. In this case, I'm going to confirm his grip by using both of my hands with the thumbs down this way. I want to keep his hand glued to my chest, like this. I'll take a step back with this leg and cut in front of him. So that from this position here, I can now force the joint of the elbow down, keeping myself in base and snapping the elbow backwards if I have to. Change side, please. So as the person grabs it this way, my hands will come in this way. One step back, and then I cut in front of him. From here, I'll put the weight on the elbow joint and lift the hand up, dropping the weight down on the back of the elbow. One, and then bring it back. One more time, please. Here you want to make sure that your thumbs are down and you keep his hand glued to your chest. That's the move. Step back and then cut in front of him so that you can now lean the leg down and hyperextend the elbow. The same technique would apply if the person would grab you by the hair. In which case you glue his hand to your head, take a step back, and then use the same principle. One, three, the idea here was pulling him back. It's to keep moving base. One, two, and then force it back. This is a defense against the kicks. Your movement would be to step back, keep your arms straight, and then from here, hold on to his foot to flip him over. Ideally, when the person throws a kick towards you, what you want to do is take a step back in base, keep your hands like this. So when the foot's coming towards me, I will step back. That's the move I want. Be sure that you have your base planted this way and not this way. So what you want is take a step back to plant yourself in base like this, with your arms this way. The position of the hand should be with the hand wrapping around the thumb to prevent the heel from coming in into your hand. So as you step back, the hand wraps over the thumb like this. That's what you're looking for. So it throws the kick. Well, that's the move I want. Wrapping the thumb so that I can then lift him up backwards once again. Right. The idea is to, in order to hit me with a kick, he needs a specific distance. Stay here guys for a second. When he throws a kick, he needs this distance to hit me with a kick. Once again, please. As I step back, he'll miss the foot. Once again. So just by stepping back, I'm safe against his kick. Just by stepping back, I'm in a safe distance. So as I step back, and if I lift my hand, I now have base, I have his leg here, so I can then flip him over and complete the motion. On here, that's the move I want. Vou jogar agora. On him, and then lift the guy up. To bring him back. Let's do the same thing from the other side. So when the person comes with a kick, I'm going to step back in base and then hold on to his foot this way. Remember that the idea of this step back is to end up in a good solid base. You don't want to stand up like this with the legs straight back. Do a slight turning of the foot so that you can be in this kind of base. So that's the move, and the hands like this, wrapping with the hands in this position. You don't want to be like this position with the hands so his heel doesn't hit the tip of your fingers. Oh, and that's the move. Just as I said, just by stepping back, you'll be safe against the kick. In order to prevent him to regain his balance and try kicking again, if you step back and grab this, he can't get his base again. From this position, you can just lift him up. One more time, for the right move. Here, and then move back. Then there's another kind of kick, when a person swings the leg around this way. You trap the arm, put it here, completely move this way. So when the person swings the leg, block here, come in, completely move this way. So the idea is when the foot comes this way, you want to have your hands and then block like a shock absorber. Your hand would slow down the foot and then wrap it up. Bang, and then give it. Bang, and then wrap. Don't shoot my foot. Yes, and wrap up. My hands have to do this motion. Right, thank you. Right, and wrap up. And wrap up. Yeah. From here, I trap the leg, come in, I'm going to brace my arm on his chest or put my hand on the chest, bring my leg behind his leg and trip him back. One. From here, I'm in base, take my time to establish a good position here and then trip him back over the leg. Control the leg, come in, bring the leg behind, and throw the leg down. The other side. One. Establish myself in here. One more time. Open up your foot. One. Come in here. If I'm against the wall and the person is coming towards me to kick me here, I can no longer step back and I'm going to be squeezed against the wall. So what I want to do here is pivot and then come back with an elbow strike.
want to stay in position and turn this way. The trick is the pivoting on this foot so that I can turn my whole body and the hand deflect the foot as it comes towards me.
And then I have an elbow strike.
One, two. That's good. One, two.
You could use either leg and your movement is the same.
You can either deflect if you use the other side. Or even if you use the same arm,
the hip would work the same way.
One, and then come with the elbows.
Let us see the same technique from this wall, so that we can have a better angle.
Make sure that your arm is not going like this in front of your body. Your arm should stay on the same level with your whole body. So when you turn, the arm is stiff. You don't want to do this move, because if you move too fast, your hand could go first and then you still get kicked from the stomach. But if you turn your whole body, even if the leg would your foot would touch you, it's still deflected by the body movement. That's the idea, so that you now can complete it in elbow strike.
Change sides and you move the elbow.
So the idea is to be here, I pivot, and now if the elbow comes in. If the attacker has a knife, your best defense is to have a gun. If you don't have a gun, run. The techniques that you're going to be seeing are in case there's nothing else you can do. If you're going to be stuck in a corner and there's nothing to do and you're going to get stabbed, then that's when the techniques should be used. Initially, if the person has a knife and is going to do the overhead attack, the movement is to do this, wrap the arm around this way, and then break his arm by bending it back. The step and the hand should come in together. One, two, keep the elbow glued to your chest and then lift the arm up. One, two. And then as I lift my shoulder up, you break the arm. You want to avoid going towards the knife. You want to do this move where you stay where you are and the knife comes towards you. That's what you want to do. Keep the elbow glued on your chest. And this elbow must be down, because if the arm is up, we could straighten the arm away. So be sure that you keep your elbows together, his elbow glued to your chest, so that you can now lift up your shoulder and have to extend the ligaments on the foot. Once again. One, glue the hand to your chest, and then lift this up. The purpose of this back hand is to prevent him from pulling the knife away. If I just use one hand, he could pull the knife away and get away with it. So the second hand is already here, so he can't pull the knife away. I'm going to wrap the arm around, keep the hand glued to my chest, and then lift the arm up, forcing him to let go of the knife. When you step forward, you want to take a step, and again, think about your base. The idea is to find yourself in base with both hands coming up this way. Keep the hand glued in your chest and then lift the arm up. It will help if when a person comes up with a knife, the first thing you want to observe is how is he holding that knife? Does he have the knife like that? Or does he have the knife like this, which indicates he's coming underhand? So again, if he's coming overhand, his knife has to be in that position. When he brings the knife up, one, glue it to your chest, and then lift the arm up this way. Change side, both. One, glue to your chest, wrap the arm around, and then lift the arm up. Step forward, go ahead. One, wrap this up, your hands should wrap in the other one, so that you cannot bring the arm back and force him to drop the knife. I think that's very well. And then let down. Back to the side. If he's not holding the knife this way, means that he's going to come this way underhand. In this case, my movement is to block the knife with the frame of the arm as I have my second hand on the elbow. So the idea is to take a step forward and at the same time have the second hand over the elbow. That's the move you want. Again, be aware of the back leg so that your leg bone is not in this kind of base, but instead you establish a good solid base this way. The movement is this one. From here, your hand will overlap your hand, and as you lean back, you will have his arm wrapped up this way, so that you can now lift this up and break the arm. One, two, you lift this up, you drop the arm.
You can't put your foot on it, drop the arm.
The idea, one, wrap the arm and bone here, adjust the arm to your chest, and as you lift your arm, you drop the mat. One, two, from here lift the arm up, so he drops the mat. One more time. One, two, and lift the arm up. Estica mais o braço, nada a ver. Posso mais esticar. One, two, and then lift the arm up. So when the person comes with his knife, catch a faca. The reason I put my arm like this is to make sure he doesn't get to me. If he comes outside of my arm, there's no danger. And if he comes on the inside, there's no danger. The purpose of my arm is to exactly to block the knife from getting to my body. So when I do this move here, it's blocked by the arm. Also, you want to make sure to put your arm with the flat part out. You don't want to put your arm this way, or it's going to hurt your arm and his arm. You want to make sure that your hand is flat out, so that the nerve radial right here on the front gets exposed and it hurts his arm much more than it hurts my arm as I block it. Once again, that's the move you want. And at the same time, the hands on the elbow to prevent him from taking the knife away and having another shot. So the idea is to block the arm as you hear and the second hand on the elbow so he can't pull the hand back. From this position, my hand will overlap his elbow, wrap it around, and then stretch the shoulder here. Let go of the knife. Yes. One more time, please. Right, that's the move. Once again. Come on here. That's the idea. In base, blocking with your knife and the second hand on the elbow. From this position, I'm going to lean back and drag him forward. I only take one initial step. I don't make a second step after that. So once I block, he is the one that's going to be dragged forward. By leaning my body weight back, I make him take a step. That is why it's so important that you find yourself in a good solid base so that you can use your body to make him walk forward. Go ahead. One, two, and then lift the arm up this way. Okay, one more time on the other side, please. So the idea is to step forward, one, two, and then from here, lift the arm up. Another variation for a knife attack is if the person comes again like this. Now this time my hand is going to come this way. You can choose whenever you want to use one or the other. It doesn't really make a difference. The idea here is to block the knife away from me. One hand like this and the second hand on the bicep. Both arms should be straight. Again my base. One. From this position, this hand slides behind the elbow and I bring him forward. And now force the arm to break backwards. One, two, and then base in front of him so I can force the arm until he drops the knife. One, two, step in front of him. I'm continually reestablishing my base, huh? So that I cannot force the arm down. So the move is one. I'm going to turn the top hand, continuously holding the wrist. When I'm going to use the force that he's pushing towards me so that I can then step in front of him and establish myself in base. Think about your base at this point so that you can, with the shoulder, force his arm up. Nice. One, two, three. That's the move. From here, force the arm up. Once again. One, two,
Three.
That might happen for.
Let us see the same technique from another perspective.
One, two, and then two.
In this technique, be sure, once again, please, when you block this, the position of my hands are like this. I want to make sure that, once again, first, please. If the person throws a knife, this is the move. If he goes out of the arm, it goes that way. If it goes this way here, it misses this way. So as if this is a triangle that goes this way, I'm blocking this move. Can you get? Once again, the purpose of the hand blocking like this is if it goes on the outside, it goes away this way and this way. The idea of the hand like this is to block exactly like a triangle here, or the tip of the triangle would be my hand. So one, two, three, and then four to that. Okay. So we're back to this side. If the person throws a knife in this way, and as I'm getting ready to do this, he decides to pull back, my hands will slide down to his hand. I will take a step forward and go behind him so that I can now twist this and get the knife away. One, two, three, and then get the knife away. One. Push a knife. Wow. And then go this way. My goal is always to bring his arm up. If the person resists, that's when my hand slides down. Be sure that you don't end up on the wrist, because it could turn, and I don't have the control of the knife the way I'd like to have it. Go to the hand, because now I have a much better grip, and I can then get a much more stronger control in his hand. Let me do this on the other side, please. If the aggressor comes with a knife and wants to bring a knife attack from the side, that's what I want. One here and the second hand over his head. One and the second hand here. Again, observe the base. So when I step, I want to make sure that I step in this kind of base. That's the move I'm looking for. One, second here, and I'll bring the knife back this way. I'm going to keep my hands glued together here so that I can now bring the arm. Hold this and bring it across. The purpose of the hand, the purpose of the hand working this way is so that I can protect the side of my body with this arm. So I want to block here, and the second hand comes over his hand so I can have a better grip by holding his hand half over the thumb. One, and here. Keeping my hands adjusted against each other so that I can bring this across. One, two, keep this together, and then three. The other side. One, the second hand comes in here, in base, and then I bring the knife underneath. Once I have the hands like this, it's almost like I want to bring the hand, swing the whole arm across. One, and then come under.
brings the knife from the other side. It's one, two, wedge my elbow on my hip so that I can step behind him and then lift the arm up this way. One, the movement is to hit both hands at the same time. So once you block this, both of your hands are going to hit the movement this way. So it's one, two, and the same leg that first initially stepped this way is going to go behind him. Be sure to be aware of the position of your leg so that you can continue to stay in a good solid base. Rest your shoulder over your shoulder so that you have the leverage of the whole body lifting this up. One, two, three. I'm continuously readjusting my base so that I always have leverage and power to lift the arm up. One, two, three. My main concern is my balance here at all times. The shoulder is glued to my shoulder. His arm is glued to my shoulder. I'm wedging my elbow on my hip, and I can now, with the leverage of the whole body, crank the arm up that way. One, two, three. And then lift it up this way. One, two, the same leg goes behind him. And then lift it up. As I step forward, with this leg, once again, lift. As I step forward with this leg, and when I hit, the same leg goes behind him. So it's one, two, three. One, two, three. It's important that this hit is a simultaneous hit so that you have a better chance to force the person's arm turning into this angle.